All right, Bill, looks like it's perfect timing. You got it.
All right, thank you. Well, and so I'll go ahead and get started because the slides are actually just pretty pictures to keep you entertained while I talk. But I want to mention, so I think open data is so poorly named. I've been working in this for about 4 years, and I'm a project manager. It reminds me about Microsoft. They call it Microsoft Projects. Like, that's the only, a schedule is all you have to know about something, have a project. And I see open data is the same kind of thing. Open data is so much more than data. And actually, in this area, if you were there last night, you heard Lightning Talks about that. The Mega Lightning Talk covered a lot of those elements that are bigger than just the data. And so I wanted to show here, the first slide is kind of an image we created as part of the Wake County Open Data work that we did to kind of represent the elements of our open data program so we didn't get lost in the idea that it was just data. And the bottom two, the yellow one, is actually represents our portal and the actually expanding our data that's available. And the one to the left of that is our policy and the process. And those are foundational for an open data program because if you don't have data to share, you don't have policies to maintain it and keep it fresh, then you don't have an open data program. However, if you just stop with those two things, you really don't have much at all. And then the next two levels were about internal engagement and integration with consumer applications. So we in Wake County, we focused on both working with our internal partners. In fact, most of the data that we have on our portal came from them. It was data that we were already sharing, but in very bad ways or poor forms. So we made it better and easier to share. And our open data program was a partnership between our GIS department and our IS department. And it a lot of the data that we started off with was data that we already had curated by our GIS department. But that internal engagement part is important, and the ability to get data into consumer applications is important. But the top one is really where it all comes together. Because even when we integrate our data with consumer applications and we work internally, if the community doesn't know about it, if they're not aware of it, we're not working with the community partners, and the civic tech environment is a big partner, but it's not the only partner, then we've kind of lost a lot of the message. So open data is more than just data, and I think that's critical for everybody to start off with. So you can go ahead. So for my government friends, what I want to just mention is that we need to treat our data, and I call it public data. Public data is an asset. Having this information out there and available helps us, improves our work, allows people to interact with us in a way that's better. So those of you who are here from government, and if your organization doesn't have an open data program, talk to some of us that are involved in this, because we've learned a lot, some the hard way, and we've copied each other, and that's good. Picasso quote that I love is, good artists copy, great artists steal. And so we've stolen from each other over the course of a couple of years, and it's great. But it is an asset to have your data out there. But civic tech is also an asset. So now I'm going to focus the next few slides on the community and why we're all here. Without civic tech, I think North Carolina has one of the most robust open data program, regional collaboration, the amount of portals, the interaction between civic tech and the entrepreneurial communities anywhere in the country. I've looked at this for years, and I don't think anybody even comes close to North Carolina on the level of collaboration, cooperation, and sharing in the community. And I think a lot of that is because, not because of the government, although I think we've done some good things, but because of civic tech and the entrepreneurial community getting together and forcing us in this direction. So if this is your first event, come to more. There's a lot going on, and these are some of the groups, and I would check out NC Open Pass if you're not familiar, if you didn't sign up that way, to see a stream of events that occur throughout the year where you can lend your expertise, your knowledge, not just technical or programmatic, but also just as a citizen to help the community get better. And so I wanted to show a couple of examples of where this is. It's a little bit dated, but it's some of my favorites, so I left it together this way. These are two examples of corporate applications and two of civic tech. And I'll go with the civic tech one first. The right-hand one is NC Food Inspector, one of my favorites because I'm on the team. And it was built originally by Code for Durham, and last year Wake County added our stuff to it. And so now we've got that started, and we're gonna push going forward to make it truly be NC Food Inspector, make a platform for restaurant inspection data throughout the whole state. CityGram is also, that comes out of Charlotte, and a fellowship program through the Brigade, or through Code for America. And that was a great example of a tool that's been used for a bunch of different purposes throughout this area. So look at CityGram, look at NC Food Inspector as examples of city tech. Yelp and Waze are great examples of how our data, government data, can make applications throughout the world a little bit better for people. And they don't need to know, per se, where it's coming from. They're using these tools anyway, and since they're already there, us sending our data to it just makes it better. Waze, Raleigh is a great example of this. They take their road closure data and add it to Waze. So if you want to be routed around the 5K rather than running into the 5K, that's a great example of how you can do that. And other organizations are doing that, sending their road closure data to Waze so they can notify their users before the first person hits it. Right? That's a great resource. And then Yelp is an example. We actually integrate our restaurant inspection data with Yelp so that when you go to Yelp and you use it, you actually get the latest inspection data for the restaurants that are in there. So if you're working with the county and you do have restaurant inspection, you're not doing that, look at that because it's a great resource. So before I jump into the next one, what I want to do is kind of just make it clear that I think a big part of this is this idea of coming at it from multiple perspectives, trying to think of everything it is, but not just focusing on getting data sets out. And for those of you who want more data out, that's great, let people know, but come with an idea of how you would use it. Because what I like to say is data that's not used is by definition not useful. And we often put data out just to put data out and then find out nobody's using it and has no use case for it. So what I want to do is there's uses out there, there's ideas in your heads, get them out, let us partner with you and get more information together. So I happen to be where I work with Wake County. I'm the open data coordinator for Wake County. I'm on the planning group for City Camp and NC Data Palooza. And I've been working with this for about 3 or 4 years since I became the open data coordinator. I think there's space for everyone to partner, but this community element of it is huge. And it also led to a big push. This community involvement led to a big push and got open data out there. So you can go ahead to the next. There was a time there was no data out there, and then, or if it was out there as an FTP site, it was sitting there, it was just people, the only people who knew it was there were the three people that asked for it, and there's like, find it here. But then all of a sudden, some leaders got pushed into, by the community, got pushed into adding more data and creating portals, and then others followed, and others followed, and others followed, and now this is a slide that shows all the portals that I could find in North Carolina, so it's not even legible. As I added, I'm like, oh, this is great, I can't even tell anymore what's happening. So there's a lot out there for you to find, and what we've done for this year's OpenPass is we've accumulated a bunch in a tool called data.world. And so go ahead to the next slide. There you go. Perfect. So this is important. Now I'm going to talk about how you can use the data, all right, in this event. So I'm on the data committee as part of my planning for Open. And actually, if you're on the data committee, can you stand up? Because we've had a bunch of people who have curated data for this event. So thank you. Not everybody's here today, but thank you. So over the years, as those portals grew, we changed how we approached our data curation. And this year, we did something a little bit different. So Wake County and a couple of people in the open data planning community got together. We came up with 4 challenges that you'll hear about in the pitch in a little bit. What we did for the data committee is we curated data from all those portals I just showed you that had relevant data to those challenges so that any team that wants to jumpstart into that has an opportunity to jumpstart into these projects. And we're there for you as a resource if you're looking at building something to help you find data and get it out so you can use it. And right now what we've done is we're sharing it on a cool tool called data.world, and it's under the organization Code for NC. So if you go to data.world/code for NC, you'll find the 4 challenges that we knew about because we prepped them. And we want you to add your challenges and your ideas out there, and we'll help you curate data from all those data sets, all those data portals to find and connect and get them into data.world so you can work with it, manipulate it, create queries to organize your data and bring it all together. So this is a new tool. They're a partner with us this year, and thank you for that. There's people available with, if you have questions on how to use it over the weekend. And from a data perspective, you can reach out to me. My contact information will be available. If you want to find data and you're having trouble finding it, I can help you connect it. Now, we're not here to do your data work for you, for those who are forming teams, but we do want to help you get a jump start on the in terms of the competition and be able to get to that minimum viable product faster by helping you just get to the data quicker, know where it is. Every one of those challenges is also linked to a a Google Doc with more information on each of the challenges, okay? So that's my contact information. If you have any questions, email me, call me, let me know. I'll be happy to help you as fast as possible.